Good morning, good morning. We are at exit 123, Interstate 40, Arizona. A place called Seligman. Time to get the show on the road. Nice to see the sunshine. Not a cloud in the sky. I mean, I was like wondering when winter is going to let its grip up. Even like in Arizona, you know, like we got snow yesterday. Nothing wrong with that, I don't mind it, but it's like I've never ever really looked forward to the sunshine until this year. But the sun is shining. I was in, we were in Oklahoma, and it was 100, I got 101 was the highest I recorded. In a truck. So it was probably 92, 90 something degrees. The truck's usually 10 degrees hotter because the engine radiates heat, I think, is why it's a little bit hotter. But anyway. We hit that, and then we coming into Arizona thinking, oh yeah, we'll be in stuff like this. And nope, we got hit with the snow and the wind and all the other stuff. A little bit of rain, but most of it was snow. And I could have gone, I had another 25 minutes left on my log. It was pushing it too close to make it to the pilot. East of Kingman, Arizona. But I would have been 10 minutes short, I think. So I wasn't gonna play around with it. Another beautiful day in the neighborhood at 44 balmy degrees. It's nice they got this asphalt reworked. Used to bounce you all over Pothole City. Looks like I'm in a jam. Hanging around two other trucks about the same speed. One car. Hitting his brakes. Whoa. Didn't expect it to be that brutal. Usually I rest my arm on the tripod, but drinking my coffee, got surprised. It's So we're going to see how quiet Vegas is. Imagine it's eerily quiet. Can't pass a solid line over a solid line. I had to wait for a broken line. So I went grocery shopping yesterday, like I said in the other video, and I ended up buying a burrito this morning from the gas station because they make their own. I don't think I'll ever buy a gas station burrito again, ever. Pre-packaged, they're the worst. Some places, you know, it's like, there's this one place that, where's that at? It's in Arizona. Or no, Mesquite, Nevada, the pilot. There's a restaurant, Maria's, in Beaver, Utah. Same company that owns both those pilots. Their burritos are the bomb. So I bought one down there, and it's like there's not even any egg in it. And there's another one in Eli, Nevada that doesn't have any egg in it. They don't have no eggs in Nevada. I don't know what the deal is. Out of potato. Oh, and then there's one in Wyoming, Sinclair. A truck stop over there, just east of Rawlins. It was all potato. For like $8. Ridiculous. Never again. That's how you learn. But I just bought one because they're homemade. They're made right there and kind of help the local economy. So when I come around opportunities like that, absolutely I will. But for the most part, we're gonna quarantine in this truck. At least the truck is moving, right? You guys can quarantine with me. Quarantine with me down the highway. Make my own coffee. Use a Mickey D's dark roast. Keurig. Oh, excuse me. Makes a nice cup of coffee. Could be out in the middle of the desert and make my own. Glad this highway has been redone. It's been a while since I've been out here, but man, I tell you, it was rough. I've got a lid, a slider lid that goes on the inside of my black cup right here to keep it from spilling over. I don't have it on right now, but on the old road, I would have to put my coffee down, put the lid on it, and hold on to the tripod. Because we'd be all over the highway. Pothole City. This actually is, for just being brand new, is kind of rough. little bouncy here and there. You'd think it would be smoother. What I mean? Brand new highway. It's a bit rough. Maybe they're gonna lay another layer on top? I don't know. Maybe, because look at the markings. Probably was going to be going on, because if it was done, you'd have a broken line down the middle, a white line to the right, and a yellow line to the left. So yeah, they're not done. This must just be the base. This will tell us up here if we're going to bounce on that bridge. That truck didn't bounce too much. Well, I don't know. Bottle of water falling on the ground. See a pothole right there? Boom! A couple more right here. Boom, 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 boom! These supply rigs have decimated the highway. I always try to split the lines when I come across that stuff to stay out of the pothole. Providing I can move over enough with the road traffic to the left of me. Thank you. So probably about 2.5 hours outside of Vegas. Roughly. Absolutely gorgeous day today. It is kind of nice, though, being out here with just the trucks. Even though truck drivers are a pain in the butt sometimes, I mean, they're just as bad as four-wheelers. There's a lot of them from other countries that bring their style of driving to here. The thing I hate the most is, though, you'll be coming up and it'll be in the hammer lane, and I'm cruising right along. And there's two vehicles, two tractor-trailers right next to each other. One guy's got his nose so close to the trailer in front of him that he's cleaning his license plate off for him. And I'm flying up there, and at the last minute, he decides that he's going to go. He looks in his mirror, starts to turn, sees me, and goes, oh, there's enough time, and pulls in there. Never once judged that I was flying. I come in, hit the left line, hit the freaking ribs in there, and I'm coming off to the edge. I'm blowing my horn. Had to slam on my brakes. Absolutely pissed. Got on the radio, told him off. And he got back over. I started to speed up again because he passed another truck. Another truck was coming over. Boom, he cut in front of me again. And that was literally, he was like a foot to 2 feet in front of my bumper when he came back over again. And he's from India, and I knew that because what he was wearing on his head absolutely pissed me off. It was totally uncalled for. He sat behind that guy forever, waited until I got there, and then cut in front of me. That's the kind of moves that truckers make that pisses me off, and it happens actually quite a bit. But now with so many different nationalities out here, American trucking has changed quite a bit. A lot of people don't even talk on the radio no more, which is kind of fine, because a lot of them are talking BS anyway, but it is nice not to have all the cars running all around. Because they cut you off as well. Feeling pretty good today. Got a decent night's sleep. A good night's sleep, I guess. good coffee. See you in a bit. Coming over the big valley. Your washer fluid getting a little low. That's when we take north to Vegas. We'll go over by the Hoover Dam. Get some video of that. A lot of houses spread over that hill there. Doing his brake procedure right. Steady pressure. He probably gets a big old fine if he goes over a certain speed through his company. Out here, we freewheeling. Actually, I wasn't freewheeling there. I had the Jake on. Full Jake. Keep it going past a certain point. See you in a bit. Fixing to come over the big valley into Kingman. Sure, everybody that's getting on the freeway can get on. Team. Rattlesnake Wash. It's a major stop on the Route 66 highway. Andy Devine, old actor from the 50s and 60s, I think, probably the 70s. See you in a bit. This intersection has always been busy. car sneak in there. It's even busy in quarantine. Down 70 miles. This guy was going to be slowing down, but I guess not. Coyote Pass, 3737. I wonder if they got snow here yesterday as well. To the left over there is Bullhead City, Laughlin, Nevada. We're going to go to the right to Lost Wages. North to Alaska. can see the impact craters. See all the light on the highway? So the impact craters, where the tires impacting the road, blowing it up. Quite a bit of them. Dodging landmines. See you in a bit.